Raymond said when he was discussing challah that Adam, he said Chava made Adam sin. Did Chava make Adam sin, or did he have free will to say, no, thank you, darling, God said we can't eat from this tree? Now, any husband who knows when his wife put, I was about to say, anybody who's married knows that when your wife puts down supper and you say, darling, God said not to eat this, it ain't going to go over too well. But Rabbi Mintz, did Eve make Adam sin, or did Adam have free will?
Okay, there's a law in the Torah called the Meisis HaMadiach. It's called a law in the Torah that if somebody gets somebody else to sin, they get punished for it. Now, when you say make somebody sin, he definitely has free will. But a person on his own many times would not do that sin on his own, but somebody coming over to him and telling, come on, it's a good thing, you'll see, it's going to be great. You have free will to refuse, but that person put him into a position, gave him the temptation, and therefore he chose to do the wrong thing. So we say the person who talked him into it is also guilty of talking into it. The person who did it is also, like you're saying, he definitely was not forced to do it. Else he takes the gun in his head and says, you better go, I'll kill you. That's a different story. But just says, Rava said, oh, the fruit is so delicious and it's going to give you a different idea in life and so on. And she talked him into it, but he definitely had free will and he was punished for it because he didn't have to listen to her. But she was wrong by
talking. They were all punished. She was punished. He was punished. The serpent was punished for convincing her.
But she was punished for eating, but also for being a person who talked him into doing evil, even though he didn't have to do it. But she made him more tempting to
she
do it. So
she presented a temptation, and he chose to take it.
Correct.
She led him to sin.
No.
Yes, she did.
Did the serpent lead Eve to sin?
I'm going to just step in.
Made her own
no, but did the serpent convince her? Was the serpent punished for convincing her?
It's like nobody has responsibility. It's always somebody else. No.
She was punished, and the serpent was punished, and he was punished. Adam was punished.
Right, but it's the way it's said, that it's her fault.
She led him to eat it, just like the serpent.
I would agree that she participated, but
she didn't participate.
Let's look.
Shh.
No, actually, the Medrash says that she convinced, she pushed them to eat it. She convinced them to eat it because she was.
She gave it to him. That's a no. She gave it to him. It says in the Torah. So she forced him. Those are the words of the Torah. She gave it to him. That's what it says. That's right.
And we have to make our own decisions.
That's
right. But when somebody chooses to tempt you, that person gets punished for tempting you.
I don't mind you saying that, but I do mind when you say.
How about if Adam gave? I have a question for you, Barbara. If Adam would have given Eve the fruit, would you still have the same problem? Right, okay, let's... Okay.
Who can I call?